just watch me dance. Just watch me dance.
Day. So we're talking about new year, new me. Is it gonna be a new you? Is it gonna be a new you? Now listen. You know what the problem is? This is basically everybody on the whole entire planet. The only reason why we never kind of stick to our New Year's resolutions is because we make a list. I said that a couple of programs back. We make a huge, long list. Nobody's gonna do that list. So I kind of summed it up. I went on vacation and I sat with myself and then I summed it up. I'm like, okay, how are we gonna do this, Yahala? Because it's not working. It hasn't been working for 1,000 years now. It hasn't been working. That list is still kind of stuck. It's like, it doesn't work, okay? Full stop, end of story. So what's that one thing that you have that you're kind of proud of yourself? It's like everybody has at least one good thing in them. We all have one good thing, hopefully, just one. So we build on that one. See the beauty of it? It's like it's already there, but we're just giving it an upgrade. See, that's why we're not kind of making it. We're not gonna give ourselves panic attacks and we're just trying to be something that we're not and we're just trying too hard. And you know what happens when you try too hard? You kind of quit at the end because it gets tiring. Now I asked a lot of people. I'm like, listen, just give me one example. I don't want three and I don't want a list. Just give me one example of new year, new me. Just give me one example. And the first one that hit my soul, man, and I'm sure it's gonna hit yours, is one person looked at me straight in the eye and said, you know what? You know what my new year, new me, new resolution's gonna be? I am going to be the main character of the story of my life. Like, what? Like, yeah, I'm gonna be the main character from now on. This year is gonna be all about me. I'm like, well, isn't that a little bit selfish? And she's like, yes. It's selfish, and it's not that I'm not gonna do selfless acts here and there. Of course I am. But I am gonna be the main character. I'm like, okay, can I steal that? She's like, yes, you can. So, that's it. That's the first one, and that's the main one. You should be the main character of the story of your life. Because when you're the main character, after that, you can take care of all the other characters that come along. Good ones, you keep. Bad ones, get away. You know, that's it. Very easy. Stay tuned, y'all. Be right back.
Hopping on a red eye. Hopping on a red eye. I can rest assured that when you're on the other end of it, looking forward to the descent and you're out. See you when I touch down. I know it seems strange, you seen you last night and I miss you already. My bed is depressed, my pillow's a victim. Got me in chills, but my hands are sweaty. And I want to fly out. Wait, you got me strung out.
Hey, this is Justin Timberlake.
This is Major Lazer.
Hey guys, I'm Ion Bondage.
Boy, yo, bro.
This is Drizzy.
Hey guys, it's Selena Gomez. They're keeping the summer hot.
This is my station.
Only on SRFM. More music, less talk.
Hey, baby. Come on in. I've been waiting for you. Sit down, relax, you know, I got a few things I've been thinking about, and I'd like to share them with you. I know things have been a little strained around here lately because of all the stuff going on outside the house, you know, the pressure, the job, all those things that can weigh you down. You know, sometimes, just sometimes, you bring that home with you. And I understand, but you know, I want us to just stop for a minute and think about how much we have together. I'm not talking about the material things, you know, I'm talking about the years that we've given to each other. The laughter, the tears, the joy, and oh yes, we can't forget about the heartbreak. But hey, we're still together. Not because we have to be, but because we want to be. I know we can make it, baby. We can make it. That's right. We've accomplished together, both going in the same direction, wanting the same things for each other. Sometimes, you know, when you say, oh, well, I gotta work late tonight, I'm gonna be working late. And I sit back and I start to wonder about who you're working with and what you're working on. Yeah. And I might get a little upset, but then, you know, you come home and you always find some little way to let me know I got no reason to worry. Oh, yeah. I know you love me. I know you love me. I know you love me. I know you're out there working for me and these kids, and we can buy things that we like. But you know something? Those things are nice, baby, but if you really want to know what I need you. That's right. Yeah, I need you. I need more time with you. I need time with your arms around me. More times to appreciate each other. That's what we need together. And more time for all those little things that we do for each other. Because you know, little things add up. That's right. They make big things. It's all those little things that can make a woman feel so special, so loved and so adored. And you do that. Yeah, you can make me feel adored. You do it when you want to. What about me? Oh, yeah, I know, I have my moments too. When I can get on your nerves, But I want you to realize that taking care of a home, the kids, working every day, that can start to wear anybody down. So when you come home at night, maybe it's not like it used to be. But you know what's there? That same old heart, the one that beats for you, baby.
Ella plays nice music, man. She's the best.
Like, you know, like February, you could still use it. That's what I'm always saying. There's always room for change. Even if it's like, let's say November 2024 and you still want to change, you still can. It doesn't have to be with the new year, with January. It doesn't have to be. But I don't know why, it just comes with the flow, you know? It's like a new year. Let's kind of just make the best of it. So as I told you, the number one New Year, New Me, New Year Resolution. That's a handful, man. That is a mouthful, mind you. Was I am going to be the main character of my life. Another one was, now get this one. I actually have been. Now the thing is, throughout the year, that person has been trying to perfect this New Year, New Me. And at this moment, you feel like you have perfected it. Okay, there's nothing called perfection. There's always room for improvement. However, you've kind of mastered it. Now, I love this one. Number two is, I'm actually very comfortable with goodbyes. What? It's a bit grim, isn't it? There, no, wait a minute, hold on. Just like I'm comfortable with hellos, hey, how's you doing? I'm also comfortable with goodbyes. I'm like, what, do you mean the cash card? They're like, no, listen, this is only to help me progress in life and to move on from things that don't benefit me anymore. How? The thing is, they can be comfortable with saying goodbye to the expectations of the person if they are not met. They are comfortable with saying goodbye to the reality of the relationship, maybe, because it goes sour. Now, I'm telling you guys, it was a whole year of trial and failure and forgiveness and things that went on until that person, you kind of reach a point where you're comfortable with it. You're comfortable with saying goodbye. Why? Because you are the main character of your story. You can only be comfortable with saying goodbye when you are the main character of the story of your life. See the beauty of it? That's the beauty of it. Okay, because it kind of has more tags coming and going. You're stronger. Only when you are the main character of the story of your life. Stay tuned, y'all. You're back.